So here we are, we have a plan in Planner, and I'd like to add a task to it. So I click here, and what I want to do is monthly. Let's say that this is for facilities in the building. So let's say that monthly we want to check the seals on the electrics cabinet. Okay, great. Let's set a due date. End of the month, and then of course we can assign this. Now, this is great. I mean, why are we doing this in Planner? It's because whoever we assign this to, they're going to get reminders and all that good stuff, and then we're going to be able to see that they have said yes, this task is complete or not, so we can actually chase them up. So this is wonderful. It's a lot better than sending them an email, but it's a little bit limited, because if I add this now, well, there's absolutely no way to make this a recurring task. I can go in, I can copy the task manually, I guess, and I could do that for the whole year and remember in advance. That's all good fun, but it could be better, couldn't it? Now, this is an oft-requested feature, and if I was to go over to user voice for Planner, we would actually say, haha, it's been planned, except the last update for that was actually years ago. So it's great that it's planned, but it still isn't here and people are waiting for this, despite the over 11,000 votes in favor. So what are we going to do? We're going to create a flow to do our recurrent tasks instead. Here we are, good old flow. For this easy example, we're just going to do a scheduled cloud flow, something which is going to run monthly. Let's call it Check Electrics. And this can start whenever. We'll test it anyway. And this is going to be a monthly thing. Create. So far, so good. You'll be very happy to hear that if I search for Planner, I'm going to find immediately things to allow me to create a task. I'm going to create the one from preview. This is like latest features rather than legacy here. But you could probably choose either. Okay, it's a little bit scary at first, but actually no. I mean, many of these fields, you see, it's allowing you to set the category on items and things like that. Many of these things we're not going to care about. So let us just say that's our plan, planner, I should say. Plan ID, this is going to be Yes. Is there a bucket we want to put that in? Yes, indeed. We want this to be a to-do item. We might also add extra buckets in there so that people could Kanban this stuff, but that's another thing. And of course, we're going to want to put something in here about the date. So let's go over here. Find the date functions. UTC now is going to give us, well, the time that the flow runs, and then we're going to do an add days, just to say we set the due date to be, oh, the next day or some such. And now the same for this part, UTC now. And of course, we're going to add some days. When you do this, be even better than me and click the add days and then insert the UTC now inside, and then you don't need to do the cut and paste like I'm doing. Let's do it this way. We're going to change this. Give them a little bit of time to complete the task. and we're going to assign the user. Now we're just going to hard code this one, but usually we would soft code this in a list or some such, or perhaps an Excel spreadsheet, so that we had some sort of roster. Okay, let's give that a test. Slow run successful. It's looking good. And of course, this can run as many times as we like for different people. As we might want to beef this up a little bit, perhaps soft code it from an Excel spreadsheet. That's what we'll cover in a future video. Thank you.